According to Indian philosophy, life is an individual effort to experience the outer world. An individual will be looking out through a maximum of 5 sense organs with the help of mind to experience the outer world. So physically, body is made up of 5 sense organs with the help of which alone one can experience the outer world. Whatever knowledge is created with the help of these 5 sense organs about the constituent elements of the world, it will be of 5 varieties. These constituent elements known through 5 sense organs are basically known as Pancha Bhutas. Everything in the world will be made up of Pancha Bhutas, including the physical structure. So Ayurveda considers that an individual extends down through the mind and further get connected to 5 sense organs to experience the whole world. So physical body is also made up of these 5 constituent elements known as Pancha Mahabhutas. Pregnancy or garbha is a fertilization of ovum and sperm in the right time to create a physical structure. Much before the physical structure is created, the individual must have decided to come down to this earth and take a physical life. As an effort of this, individual will be transforming into the mental plane and then getting connected to the 5 physical sense organs, so that an individual in toto is created. Our effort is to create a maximum healthy status of mind and a maximum healthy status for the physical structures. As a preparation to the conception, everybody should bear in mind that mind should be healthy as much as possible, and physical structures are healthy as much as possible, since these 2 things are transferred directly from the parents to the progeny. So here we will be trying to explain the modes by which you can keep a healthier mind and you can ensure that the physical structures are also healthy, so that a healthy progeny is ensured herewith. Once the fertilization is taken place in a very pleasant atmosphere and subsequently the pregnancy is confirmed, it is important to see that the pregnancy is carried forward in a very smooth and healthy way. The period of 9 months can be divided into 3 portions: first trimester, second trimester and third trimester. The first 3 months is very important for having a healthy implantation of the fetus. For that, what we suggest is nursing care by the husband himself, or a reliable nurses will ensure that overall care of the lady is comfortably managed. Food items which are dominant with butter, ghee and milk in the required amount will ensure that the body is sufficiently lubricated and made healthier, so that the movements inside the body is smooth and results in a very healthy implantation of the fetus. First 3 months are important for certain digestive disorders like vomiting and all, which will not be stopped with any other medicines. So these kind of food items will ensure that intestinal movements are smooth, and subsequently the vomiting and all is controlled without having any artificial medication. First trimester is also important for the extra desires the pregnant woman will be expressing, because there is an additional development of heart for the fetus and desires will be expressed through the mother herself. These desires have to be fulfilled as much as possible to see that the child is also satisfied with whatever desires he is developing in his mind. We have to take care to see that whatever desire is there, it doesn't go against the basic structures or health of the mother and the child. rest of the desires can be fulfilled, so that the development in the initial stages of the mind and the body is made smoother. The second trimester is important for the full development of the mind, and this is one of the important aspects Ayurveda is trying to offer to the world. Development of the mind is ensured actually in the fifth month. From the third month onwards, the fetus will be starting to get the experience of the mental plane directly from the mother. Hence, the emotions like irritation, agitation, anger, anxiety, tension, stress, etc. have to be reduced or restricted as much as possible, because these emotions are directly transferred to the child and it will be reflected in the growth of the mind of the fetus as well. In the third trimester, eighth month is most important. Even though the physical growth of the child is complete, the essence of the fetus or an individual body known as ojas will be traveling between the child and the mother, and it will not be stabilized. So we have to ensure that the eighth month is very, very smoothly passed, so that the establishment of the ojas or the essence of the physical body is done very well in the child. Ninth month onwards, you can expect the delivery on any date. So we have to ensure that movement of the body in the subtle plane and the mental plane is very smooth. So use of oil externally and oily things like ghee or milk internally, up to the requirement of the mother and child, will ensure that movements in the subtle parts of the body is very, very comfortable. Intestinal movements also has to be made smoother with whatever medication is needed, so that downward movement through the intestine will be normally conducted, and that will be contributing to the easy passage of the fetus through the delivery passage. Just after the delivery is over, we have to ensure that the movements in the body or vayu which are severely disturbed throughout the body is restored itself. For that, we have to console the mother and made her happy, so that movements disturbed as a result of the strain of delivery is re-established from the physical plane as well as the mental plane. Once the movement is re-established and the mother is relaxed, the disturbed and weakened intestine has to be taken care of. Basic tonics like milk or ghee, along with the digestive medicines like pepper or ginger in very small doses, can be induced to see that the digestive process is again re-established. Before giving any other nourishing things or even medication, we have to ensure that the digestive system is regained first, then whatever is introduced through the intestine will be absorbed well and distributed all over the body for the purpose of regaining the body. Usually this kind of re-establishing the body will take 1 month to 1.5 months time. Till then, any kind of strenuous activities and over eating and heavy foods have to be carefully avoided, so that strain due to the delivery is completely avoided and body is regained totally from the strain of the delivery. Throughout the pregnancy, we have to ensure that the movements of the intestine is made smooth as much as possible. From the intestine, only rest of the movements are ensured. So any kind of difficulties that could be created in the intestinal movements, like motion or urine or any other vomiting, sneezing, coughing, all movements which are related or making impact on the intestinal movements have to be made very smoother. Any urges which will be preventing these movements have to be carefully executed without straining rest of the body. Any heavy food items and spicy food items have to be restricted, and oily and masala items have to be limited. Emotions like anger, agitation or anxiety should be limited, to see that the mind is also pacified at all stages of pregnancy.
Every individual is unique, and Ayurveda respects all the levels of an individual. It offers natural ways to heal people of all their sicknesses in a physical plane or mental plane. It empowers humans to take responsibility for their own well-being. This time-tested medical science is very cost-effective and time-tested. To summarize, Ayurveda is an ancient science for modern lifestyle, which aims as consciousness-based approach for their own healthy and well-being.
Leshuna Kshiram is a preparation which can be made easily at home, and it is done with garlic processed in milk, and it is a good medicine for improving the lactation. It will definitely show its result in improved breast milk within 2 or 3 days time.
This time we have a small preparation with garlic, which will be utilized for the improvement of lactation, especially after delivery. What we require to prepare this is just few garlic pieces.
So these are the garlics before peeling. And I'll just show few peeled garlic pieces as well. Of garlic, that's all.
100 ml of milk.
So we should then get 100 ml here.
And water. 400 ml of water.
Sure.
You can take 8 to 10 pieces of garlic.
Sure.
It is tied into a piece of cloth.
Do we need to crush this, or we can directly tie this?
Yeah, you can slightly crush it and then put it in a piece of cloth.
Any cloth is fine, or it needs to be a muslin cloth or cotton cloth.
Before, muslin.
So we've got these garlic pods just crushed like this, not completely into a paste. And this is a piece of the muslin cloth. We have this muslin cloth with us. And whatever chopped or crushed garlic pods we are going to tie into this. Take the four ends together. Make it all together a nice funnel. Keep another cotton string ready so that you can beautifully tie this off. And just to save our time, we've got this already tied, crushed garlic put in. Yes, then what do we do?
You can take the kadai and keep it on the flame.
Sure.
Pour 100 ml of milk into the kadai.
So it goes into the kadai.
Number 200 ml of water.
200 ml of water. Is the ask measures 200 ml. So we need 200 or we need 400?
400 ml of water is needed.
Sure. So the milk and the double the quantity of water.
Yes. Then the potli can be kept immersed in that with the help of a stick.
Just rush to your backyard, like any of the twig, very simple, a twig from the backyard itself. You tie your crushed garlic pods into this, tie to the stick, and immerse the potali into the milk. The stick remains over the pot. And this should remain like this for how long?
It should be boiled at least for 1 hour, so that the milk is reduced into whole liquid is reduced into 100 ml.
So we evaporate all the water that is added.
Yes.
And just balance whatever 100 ml milk was.
Yes,
there. We take that in balance.
till then it has to be boiled. It may take nearly 1 hour time boiling. Once it reaches 100 ml, you can switch off the flame.
When can the women start using this? Soon after delivery, or they have to wait for some time before starting this?
Soon after delivery, it may not be required sometimes. Probably after 1 week and all, usually this is required.
100 ml should be taken once a day, twice a day?
According to the need, can be used even twice a day, otherwise minimum once a day.
And which time of the day or night we have to use this?
After food, it may be preferred, especially in the night hours.
So like a bedtime medicine?
Bedtime medicine.
Once a day?
It can be used once
a day. And if second time we have to give, then what would be the preferable good time for this?
Morning after breakfast, it can be used.
That should be a wonderful, easy method for having a good lactation.
Now it is ready. You can switch off the flame.
To remove this immediately or wait till it cools?
Yeah, you can wait till it cools down. Sure. And that totally has to be squeezed out.
When mothers have less milk, is that the only time this milk can be given, or there are some other indications also where people can have milk boiled with garlic?
This can be used for many other purposes. Basically, this is a tonic for improving the breast milk. Because, you know, breast milk is the primary option for a newborn child, and that is supposed to be the best option available in the world.
True, very
so
true.
Whatever is improving the breast milk, that should be widely accepted, and this is a very big traditional know-how to improve the breast milk just after the delivery.
How long the lady can have this?
Usually you can have it for 3 months and all, minimum, which is a base period where the child is totally dependent upon the breast milk. After that, child goes with some other feed also, then maybe this much lactation is not needed. Basically, after 3 months, she can utilize it for improving or maintaining the quality and quantity of milk.
Thank you very much, sir. For our viewers, this must have been the most essential, most important tip on how we can improve the lactation of the newly delivered ladies. Now, another question, I come back to my first question. Apart from lactation, does this milk have any other benefits?
This milk also can be utilized for most of the stomach disorders, lack of digestion, acidity, bloated feeling, gas formation and all. This is a very good remedy. Continuously, if you take it for 1 week or 2 weeks, you see that your stomach is improved, digestion is improved, bowel movements are improved. You feel very light with the stomach also.
I have this a very primary question before you answer. That this milk only ladies should drink for gas trouble or any other, or even men can drink?
Anybody with any disorder of intestine can take it. And this is also a very good medicine for primary ailments related to the heart as well. To improve the strength of the heart, we give this same preparation, especially before manifesting it in a disease format. Weakness of the heart can be improved very well with this medicine. So this is a medicine which can be easily made. It has got a multi-purpose. It can be utilized by anybody having these sort of difficulties.
Very simple remedy.
Now it is cool, you can squeeze that bodily. Pour it into the glass.
No need to filter it.
No need to filter it.
Any need to add sugar?
No, as such it can be used.
So 100 ml milk, garlic milk is ready.